Hi, I'm Tim from Scoop. From time to time, we come across users who can no longer access their MikroTik routers even after a reset. This could be due to a number of reasons, but it's more than likely software related. Luckily, MikroTik have a simple tool called Netinstall to assist with flashing RouterOS software onto your device. In this video, we'll show you how it's done. You'll need physical access to your MikroTik device, which means this process cannot be done remotely. Netinstall is designed to work with Windows operating systems, and you can download a copy of the latest version from MikroTik.com. It's important to ensure the version of Netinstall corresponds with the RouterOS version, so make sure you download the appropriate package. All we need now is an Ethernet cable to connect to the router. This can be done through a switch, though we generally recommend plugging in directly to eliminate any extra points of failure. In order to get our router to communicate with our software, we need to configure separate IP addresses on our computer and Netinstall. You can use any IPs as long as they're within the same network subnet or range. In our example, we'll be using 192.168.1.1 in Windows. No gateway or DNS is required since this will only be a local connection. It's also recommended that all other network connections are disabled. Once this is done, run Netinstall as administrator and navigate to the net booting menu. Make sure boot server is enabled and insert an IP address. In our case, 192.168.1.2, then save the changes by clicking OK. Now that we are ready to accept connections in Netinstall, MikroTik routers need to be connected via their boot port. This is usually Ethernet number 1, but be sure to check your device's datasheet to confirm this. You'll also need to put your router in net booting mode in order for Netinstall software to recognize them. To achieve this, you need to hold in the reset button while powering up the router. Keep it held for around 15 to 20 seconds, and it should appear in the device list. Once you get to this point, simply select your device and the packages you downloaded earlier, then click Install. This will completely format the NAND storage and install a fresh copy of RouterOS. If you want to retain your configuration, make sure Keep Old Configuration is selected before starting this process. The original RouterBoot can be reinstated by running the upgrade feature in RouterOS. Once the package has been installed, press the reboot button and you should be able to access your router once booted up. In some cases, it may not actually be an OS corruption, but rather an issue with RouterBoot. Think of this as the BIOS of your router, which is responsible for its booting process. MikroTik are kind enough to include a backup of this bootloading software if it's ever required. It's as easy as keeping the reset button down for 3 seconds while powering up your device to start this process. Netinstall is a great tool to mitigate software-related problems in RouterOS, and devices can be reinstalled in minutes. We recommend following this process before coming to any conclusions about faulty hardware. If you want to learn more, check out the links in the description, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Tim from Scoop.